I understand that it gets a bit confusing because we talk about aquatic weeds, oh, but the weeds are good for the fish, and we talk about invasive species, but Eurasian water milfoil has been in Lake Scugog for probably 50 years. And so it's fair to say it's probably naturalized over that time. And yeah, it's unsightly, it's not fun to swim in, and it gets in the way of propellers and so forth, but really, fish have thrived. Starry stoneward is a really interesting aquatic macrophyte. Because not only does it have this hard, crunchy architecture, so it's like barbed wire for larger fish species, but it also, because it just hangs above, it doesn't have a true root system, so it's just hanging above the sediment. It actually creates an anoxic layer, so a very low oxygen environment. Fish need oxygen, so fish are not going to be hanging out there because there's not a lot of oxygen. Another bad thing about a low oxygen environment in a very nutrient-rich lake like Lake Scugog is that the nutrients that are bound up, that are just hanging out in the sediments, they get freed up because of the chemistry. And so those nutrients are now available for the algae. So starry stonewort was first reported in Lake Scugog a few years ago. It's probably been here for longer than that. But what we want to see is how is it interacting with the native aquatic plants, because we've got lots of native aquatic plants in the lake, as well as Eurasian water milfoil, which the name suggests it was an aquatic invader many, many decades ago. So we kind of have to look at it as the lesser of two evils, that Eurasian water milfoil is an invasive, but starry stonewort may be a less desirable species in the lake. And so this three-year study is going to help us understand how those two interact and what impact they're having on the lake.